Hey, what's going on guys? Welcome back to the channel, The IT Guy, and today we'll be learning about the fundamentals of Node.js. Now, this is going to be a series of videos where we'll be learning the concepts of Node.js and learn how to code in Node.js. So, if you are new to my channel, consider subscribing at the end of this video if you are interested in the upcoming videos as well. Also, this video is for complete beginners who have no idea or a little bit idea of Node.js. And also for those developers who have little experience in Node.js and want to brush up their skills in it. So, as far as the prerequisites are concerned, I will say that you must have a basic knowledge of JavaScript. I'm not asking that you have to be a pro in it, but you must have a basic knowledge about it, like how to declare variables and all that stuff, DOM manipulations and all that. Now, actually, I'm also thinking to start a simple crash course of JavaScript where I'll quickly teach you how to work on JavaScript and how to do DOM manipulations and all that stuff. So if you are interested in that, tell me about it in the comment section and we'll see if that video comes up soon. Now let's start with Node.js. So now what is Node.js? Node.js is basically a JavaScript running on the server side. Now for years, JavaScript was thought as a client-side language that only runs in the browser, which actually made it fast but also extremely limited. And it was used for improving UIs, making sliders, animations, validation on client side and all that stuff. But now it can be run on the server side by Node.js. And it is built on Chrome's V8 JavaScript engine, which is extremely powerful. And in my opinion, Chrome is the best browser. Now, your thoughts might be completely different and there's nothing wrong in that, but in my opinion, Chrome is the best browser that I have used and it's built on that. Now, Node.js can be used to build fast and scalable web applications, and Node.js uses an event-driven, non-blocking I/O model which makes it lightweight and efficient. Now, it's completely fine if you don't understand the last line, because we will be seeing about it further in this series of videos. So let's get over it. So now let's talk about the non-blocking I/O model of Node.js, which is one of the most important advantage, or I would say the most important advantage of Node.js. Well, let's first talk about some other server-side technologies like PHP or Ruby on Rails or many others. So let's take example of PHP here. So when you build a PHP application on any server like a Apache server, the each connection or the request that you make to the server spawns a new thread which takes up the system memory, and it will eventually max out whatever the maximum memory load handles. So basically, it needs to wait for one process to finish before it starts the next one, and this works in a synchronous manner. But for Node.js, it works on a single thread and it works on asynchronous manner. So it can support tens of thousands of concurrent connections at once. So because of this, it optimizes the throughput and scalability. Now that's the reason why Node.js apps are extremely fast and efficient. Now if you still have some other doubts in your mind, then it's okay, it happens if you're starting a new language. Once you start working on these languages, you will get to it how these things work. So moving ahead, Node.js uses something called as the event loop. So Node.js runs on the single thread, which we have discussed before. So it supports concurrency via events and callbacks. So it uses an event emitter class, which is used to bind events and event listeners. So now if you look at the diagram, you will get a bit more idea about the event loop. So every new task is handled by the event loop. It binds the event and event listeners to it. So once the process of execution is completed, then it returns a complete callback, and because of which the next process goes into execution. So this whole complete process is done by the event loops. Well, if it still sounds gibberish to you, then just keep this in mind that other technologies like PHP uses synchronous call, while Node.js works on asynchronous, which makes it more faster than them, and it uses events and callbacks to handle the execution. So now let's take a look at the things that we can build using Node.js. So you can create real-time services like chatbox, games, using socket.io, which we'll be seeing. It's a really popular module used in Node.js. And you can create CMS, social application, blogs with Node.js. You can also create REST APIs and other backend applications. Basically, you can build anything that is not CPU intensive. And if you are really thinking of starting some new language, then I really suggest that Node.js is the language you should be looking forward to. So moving ahead, what is NPM? So in the next video, we will see the installation process. So when we install Node, NPM is also installed. So NPM is basically Node.js package manager. It is used to install other modules and packages in Node applications. And all the modules that you will install, they will get stored in a Node modules folder. So that's basically a brief idea what NPM is. Next, let's see about the popular Node.js modules. So first is Electron. It's really popular and it is used to build cross-platform native web applications using HTML, CSS and JavaScript. Now, in simple words, if I say that you can use web technology languages like HTML and CSS and build desktop applications on any platform, it can be Windows, Mac or Linux. You just have to code it once and you can compile it for all the three platforms. So it's really popular nowadays. Second, we will talk about is Express. It is a backend framework for web development. We will be seeing how to use Express in further videos. Next is Socket.io, which is a server-side component for web sockets. As I mentioned earlier, it can be used to make that chat box, which is really a real-time application. So next is Connect. It is an extensible HTTP server framework, which is a baseline for Express. Next is Mongo or Mongoose. These are wrappers to interact with MongoDB database. Now MongoDB is a NoSQL database, and the reason why MongoDB is more popular because it is more compatible with Node, but it's not like you can use only MongoDB database. Node.js has support for MySQL, SQLite, PostgreSQL, so you can use other databases as well, but MongoDB is more preferred by developers because it is more compatible with Node.js. So next is CoffeeScript. So we have CoffeeScript compiler, which is basically a superscript of JavaScript, too many scripts. And next we have Pug, which is a new name for Jade, if you have heard about it. It's a template engine used in Node. You can imagine it like HTML. If you just Google it, you will see the syntax of it is mostly similar to HTML. So yeah, these are some of the popular modules in Node.js, and in further videos, we might be seeing how to use these modules in code. So I hope you will enjoy watching those tutorials as well. So saying that, this completes our tutorial for the introduction to Node.js. I hope I haven't lost you in the middle. So in the next video, we'll be seeing how to install Node.js and do basic programming in it. So press the bell icon to get notification if you haven't subscribed to my channel, and I'll see you next time. Bye bye.